Angel turns back to Lucan. You too, his eyes hiss. Get on back to the house. I'll catch you later. And, fearful after Kev, Lucan slopes off, weakly into shadow. Angel swings his head around and looks at us with menace. My fear returns for real. I see that Alaia is as malleable as me. He points up Ocean Avenue, his meaning clear. Walk. Docile, she and I comply, on a forced march, 2 blocks northwards, back to the carcass. Through the concrete columns, I can see that the cars and cops have all gone. Angel points us through a hole in the wire netting fence, then steers us towards the inland end of the building, where there's a bare, unfinished stairway, lacking any kind of containing walls, balusters, or handrails, rising 11 stories to the top. He stands at the bottom of this, still holding us with his gaze, and points up. Come on up, you little monkeys, he says with the ceremonial glee of some infernal pixie ringmaster. Let's breathe the fumes in and paint the night red. As Alaia and I step forward, I'm startled to realize that the vicious, lisped exuberance of this utterance is in fact the very first thing he has spoken aloud since my powers were transferred into him, despite the barrage of verbiage that feels as if it's been fired through the air since then.